time, who gives his bride away to be married?
I do.
Thank you. Go get her, Tiger. You may all be seated. Well, first of all, let me start off by welcoming all the friends and family of Michael and Tracy. We are gathered here today at their invitation to share in a very important moment in their lives, a celebration of their marriage to one another. But today is also a celebration for the rest of us. It's a pleasure for us to see this love in bloom, participate in a union of two people so wonderfully suited for one another and for the free food. Today, Michael and Tracy are getting married. Now, some of you out there have already experienced this joyous occasion. So by show of hands, how many married people do we have here? I'll look around, see the hands go up. You've done the grand deed.
Yeah.
Now, by show of hands, how many single people do we have here? Look how unhappy those poor souls are. Now, whether you are married or single, you're all fortunate to attend the wedding of Michael and Tracy and the start of their life today as husband and wife. But that's not the beginning of this love story. You see, every once in a while, happenstance plays a big part in Cupid's plans for romance. Out of the 7 billion people in the world, these two happen to find each other amidst all the trials and tribulations of living their lives, manage to meet, fall in love, and quickly realize they both had found the one person they've been waiting for all their lives. Life was grand for these two, but it was missing one thing, taking that next step and getting married. Ladies and gentlemen, that happens now. For today, May 19th, 2018, these two become one. Out of the routine of ordinary life, the extraordinary has happened. They found each other, fell in love, confirming their love with their wedding today. Now, the ceremony of marriage in which you come to be united is one of the oldest ceremonies in the world. Marriage is a gift that we give ourselves totally to one another. Marriage is the clasping of hands, the blending of two hearts, the union of two lives into one, and your marriage must stand not by the authority of the state or the seal on your wedding certificate, but by the strength and power, the faith and love you have for one another. And remember, at the end of today, you will be married. But happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. In marriage, the little things are the big things. Never being too old to hold hands. Let's remember to say, I love you each and every day. Let's try that now. Never going to sleep angry. Your courtship should not end with your honeymoon, but continue throughout your lives together. It is standing together, facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers your entire family. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. But most importantly, it's not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner. Now with that, I know you're all very excited, so let's begin with some very important words. Now, these are two simple words that carry so much significance. These two spoken words are not to be taken lightly. They are the pledge, declaration, and affirmation of why you're here today, your I do's to one another. Now, Michael and Tracy, you're facing one another and holding one another's hands. And even though you have friends and family here, remember these words, especially for the two of you, your pledge to one another. I will have Michael go first because he might as well find out now that Tracy will always have the last word. Do you, Michael, take Tracy to be your wife, your partner in love, your best friend, and your one true love? You promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others, and holding only unto her. Thank you. Do you, Tracy, take Michael to be your husband, your partner in life, your best friend, and your one true love? You promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others, and holding only unto him. Thank you. Now, with these words you two just exchanged, I would ask that you always treat yourself, but most importantly, each other, with respect. Remind yourself often of what brought you together today. Give the highest priority of tenderness, gentleness, and kindness that your marriage deserves. And when frustration and difficulty assail your marriage, as they do from every relationship from time to time, focus on what feels right, between the two of you. When each of you take responsibility for the quality of your life together, the quality of your life together will be marked by abundance of happiness that will lead to that everlasting relationship of love. But you know, sooner or later, we begin to realize that love is more than verses on Valentine's and romance in the movies. We begin to know that love is here and now, real and true, the most important thing in our lives. For love is the creator of our favorite memories and the foundation of our fondest dreams. Love is a promise that is always kept, a fortune that can never be spent, a seed that can flourish in the most unlikely of places, and this radiance that never fades, this mysterious and magical joy, is the greatest treasure of all, one known only by those who love. Now, I'd like to take another moment to talk about love, and I've chosen a reading from the amazing Roy Croft, just for the two of you. I love you for not only what you are, but for what I am when I am with you. I love you for not only what you have made of yourself, but what you are making of me. I love you for the part of me that you bring out. I love you for putting your heaped up hand in my heart and passing over all the foolish weak things that you can't help dimly seeing them. I love you for drawing out in the light all the beautiful belongings that no one else had looked quite far enough to find. I love you because you're helping me make a lumber of my life, not a tavern, but a temple. Out of the works of my everyday, not a reproach, but a song. I love you because you have done more than any creed could have done to make me good, more than any fate could have done to make me happy. You've done it without a touch, without a word, without a sign. You've done it by being yourself. And now to the most important part of the ceremony, the exchanging the rings and the vows. May I have the rings, please? Rings that I'm holding, well, they're very important in the significance. They're made of a precious metal, and she reminds us that love is neither cheap nor common, but love is costly and dear to all of us. Their shape and design of a circle should remind us that love should always be continuous. Whether you're together or apart for even just a moment, let these rings be a constant reminder of the promises you're making today. And with that, a big breath and go ahead. Placing on that left hand ring finger. Hold onto her hand, look in her eyes, and ask and repeat after me. I, Michael, take you, Tracy, to be my wife, to have and to hold, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to honor, from this day forward. And with this ring, I promise my love to you for as long as we both shall live. Oh, yeah. Hold on, nice and tight, look into his eyes, and ask him to repeat after me. Hi, Tracy.
Hi, Tracy.
Take you, Michael.
Take you, Michael.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to honor.
To love and to honor.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
And with this ring.
I promise my love to you
for as long as we both shall live. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Friends and family, can you get an oh, yeah, please?
Oh, yeah.
Let's take a moment to look at those rings. Pretty amazing sight, huh? Hold those up so everybody can see your bling. How about a round of applause for those rings? Symbol of your union today, a token of commitment you two have made to one another. May they always remind you that your lives are now bound together by devotion, faithfulness, your friends, your family, and now a life shared as one. And in order to make this relationship work, it will take love. That is the core of your marriage and why you're here today. It will take trust to know that in your hearts you truly want what is best for one another. It will take dedication to stay open to one another and learn to grow together. And it will take faith to go forward together without knowing exactly what the future brings, but most importantly, it's a commitment to hold true to the journey you both have pledged to today. So, let's do a quick review, shall we? You stated your I do's, you pledged your vows, you asked each other's hand in marriage, you exchanged your rings, showed the words of love in the entire gathering. I guess there's really only one more thing for me to do. And that is to read this 45-minute sermon on marriage. Base all other kisses on. No pressure on your side. Are you ready, sir? Tracy, are you ready? Friends and family, are you ready?
Yes!
It goes without saying, then, by the power invested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss your bride.
Yeah.
Oh, no, through the vow. Through the vow. Aw, come on, give her a kiss.
Thank you, friends and family. Ladies and gentlemen, I present you Mike and Tracy, officially husband and wife.
Thank you, Mike.
Take your first steps. Let's keep that applause going, everyone.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's
a
great way to meet. Connected to the
Bluetooth.
Yeah.
Star Wars.
Star Wars.
I have a
beam.
Yes, it's
Star Wars.
And you can actually pull
me
out and walk down the aisle.
Now, you've been working. That's a great rehearsal. Let's try that one more time. We now invite everyone over here to the patio for our traditional tea ceremony. Thank you, everybody. Yeah, that's what I was hearing, was Star Wars, right?